Hey y'all, praise the Lord. Just got back home not long ago, finally sitting down and relaxing. As you can see, I got a lot of sun today. And where did that happen? Over at Cooters Place in Luray. Went over for the second annual car and truck show, and let me tell you, wasn't disappointed. There was a lot of cool classics and some newer cars there. One in particular I've never seen before in person. I've only seen it on TV. But before we get to that, I gotta let you know, the background music I own no rights to. The Shenandoah Valley Mustang Club of Winchester put the show on, and they brought Rick the DJ in to provide the music. So once again, we own no rights to any of this music. Now, if you like what you see, make sure you hit the thumbs up, hit subscribe, and hit that bell notification. That way, you stay up to date with everything that we're doing. And before we get on to the show, just a huge shout out to Brother Kenny. He went up and braved the sun with me, and we had a great day of fellowship. Thanks, bro. So now let's sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
1 John chapter 14, verses 1 through 3. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also.
That was one of the cool things that, my family did. Mom and Dad would load us in the car and go for a Sunday ride.
Right.
Sometimes it was just to the airport and watch planes land.
Yeah. But those are the special moments, though.
Yeah. But yet, all these years, I remember it.
Oh, yeah. I can understand that.
I spent the summer of 1980 in Montpelier, Vermont.
When my grandmother,
one of my cousins, David, he every day after work he came and picked me up. We went out fishing, and then he would take me over to his dad's restaurant.
Oh, okay.
Called the Feed Bag. It was an old barn that they converted into a restaurant.
Oh wow! Hey, that was neat.
Yeah. So, fishing in Vermont as a 10-year-old kid, it was pretty darn cool.
I bet. I remember my grandmother used to take me up to Montrose. There was a drugstore up there, and they had a restaurant inside of it where you sat on bar stools and you ordered your breakfast. And see, when I was growing up, if you went out to eat, that was a big thing.
Yeah.
And we didn't do it often, but when we did, it was something.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
And man, I tell you, I love going with her when we went there. Or she'd take me to Texas to see my aunt. She took me everywhere.
The other big thing that I remember was going with Mom on a Saturday morning to Kmart for the blue light specials.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
And they had the cafeteria back then, and so we would always get something to eat at the cafeteria.
I remember.
And then do the shopping and the blue light specials.
Yeah. And they announced it over loudspeaker when a blue light came on.
Yes.
Yeah. I remember that.
Now see, these are all fond memories that, here we are at our age remembering them, 40 years ago.
Yeah. We have to build them with the kids.
We got to build them, somehow, some way.
Yeah.
Hey y'all, praise the Lord. It's Dave with Brother Kenny. Welcome back to God, Cars, and Bikes. Today we're up here in Luray at Cooters Place for their second annual car show. So sit back and relax and enjoy the show. And then, it's a Cobra, the supercharger on it. It is a GT500. But here is truly the only Mustang that I love.
Yeah.
Yep. The 70 Boss 302. To me, this is what a Mustang is.
Sure.
And it is a Mr. Manual. A stick shift, even better. Wow, look at the period correct Goodyear polyglass tires on it. The louvers with the little wing. That's, oh man, that's nice. And of course, if we didn't see a General Lee or two up here. And this one is a Mr. Manual. Yeah. Yeah, a bunch of autographs on the dash. Now, do you know how many of these they tore up in making the show?
I couldn't even tell you.
Fastback, 66 maybe? 65, huh? 65, with the 4-speed manual in it. Yeah. Hey now.
How you doing? Are
good. You don't have Lambo doors on this, do you?
No, sir.
Oh, shoo. They belong on one car. And they even decided to stop using them.
Yes, sir.
I'm not a fan of them.
They pain in the butt.
Yeah, I can imagine, because you got to push out and then up, where when they were built and designed for them, they just went straight up.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep.
We like to keep the classic. Wow.
Yeah.
I
got the Bumblebee. So
yeah,
I know.
Do you?
Yeah. 2012.
Yeah, yeah, it's really cool because all his the stick, you know, pinstripe, what do you call it, the all the decals, you know, all, you know, actually have the Transformers things in it,
the
language of the primes is on it. It's cool.
You guys even got the tail lights as well.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah. I've been looking at them as well. I like to get new set.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're really nice. Yeah,
because I looked it up. They only made 1,450 of them?
Yeah, I think
it's
something like that.
Yeah, I didn't know what I bought, and he didn't know what he sold.
that's when it's good to happen.
Yeah.
Are y'all filming for YouTube?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, what's y'all's thing?
Right here, God, Cars, and Bikes.
All right.
We like to talk about the things of God, you know, and just share the scriptures. But I watch a lot of YouTube, and I was like, you know, some of the stuff that you hear at different car shows, people talking, the cussing, and this and that. It's like, you know what? I know people don't want to always hear that. You know, they would like to hear, you know, something that's, well, that, yeah, something edifying, something uplifting, but still seeing the cars, still seeing the bikes, the trucks. Or just the cruising out. You know, we came from over in Fredericksburg. So coming up over the mountain, you know, it was really cool. I had one of the cameras on, you know, just to get going up the mountain. I mean, how awesome is that? But you're not hearing all that nastiness that too many people of today have. So decided, you know what? We have a platform. It's called YouTube. I watch it, so why not, you know, start putting out stuff on it?
You know?
God, cars, and bikes. Yep, and so we're just an upstart, but it was like God told us not to despise small beginnings. You always got to start someplace. You know?
My business. I've been doing it for 11 years. I've been in business for myself now for almost 2 years.
Oh, wow.
And the good Lord above is really blessed. It's so good.
Slow. Laying low flooring.
Out of Sturgis Draft, Virginia.
It's amazing how far you, you know, you look back and how far you come.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're exactly
right. Yep, so. That's why we're out here.
Well, you enjoy the day. It is beautiful.
It is beautiful. We caught the rain coming across, but it's all good. She ain't that dirty, but that's my red Corvette right there.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah, so. All right, guys. Bless you.
Yes, sir.
Cool stuff. And see, here's another classic. Now, that's a Ford Ranger. Boy, haven't the Rangers changed over the years?
I know.
I mean, from this to the little things. But even these are classic. They're nice. And I'm not the Ford guy.
But it's nice.
Yeah, it's a 70.
You're like me, I get credit when it's good.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's fun to mess with people, you know, and, you know, talk smack about the brands and all, but...
Yeah.
You know, let's face it, I mean, there's a lot of nice stuff out there if you're into the car scene.
Right.
I mean, I like it. Even the long bed.
Yep.
I mean, that is a long bed. But that's pretty cool. Hopefully we can see through that window, but just nice and classic.
This here is a Bricklin SV1. This is the car that I said I have never seen before in person, only on TV. It's a two-seater sports car that was built from 1974 to late 1975. The car was noteworthy for its gull-wing doors and composite bodywork of color-impregnated acrylic resin bonded to fiberglass. Assembly took place in St. John, New Brunswick, Canada. Production of the SV1 ended with just under 3,000 cars built, with an estimated 1,700 Bricklins surviving as of 2012. Though it looks very similar to a DeLorean, there was no relationship between the two companies. Malcolm Bricklin founded Subaru of America, Incorporated, manufactured the Bricklin SV1 that you see here, imported the Fiat X19 and the Fiat 124 Sport Spider along with the Yugo. This particular Bricklin was for sale for a whopping $32,000.
Of course, the dune buggy I think is pretty darn cool too. That would be a lot of fun. Hey y'all, we finished up another video and I just want to thank you for taking the journey with us. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up button, press subscribe and the bell notification, and consider sharing it. I'm sure there's friends and family that would love to see it. And before we go, I just want to encourage you, like we were talking with that family today, don't despise small beginnings. It's really important. We all start someplace. So again, till the next video, be blessed.